Hello everyone, it's RetroGamingNow, back with the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. As you can see, we have not been doing so well recently, and that's because I've been trying to get a win with Blue Baby. But I can't seem to do that right now, so I think I'm going to use Eden, because we have 11 Eden tokens from all of our mom's heart kills. Cellar 1, okay. We start with a nail, and if we also have something where the damage decreases rapidly as the thing gets further away, so looks like we want to be very close to our enemies when using this. We do have 7 base damage, which is pretty good. Okay, so yeah, we've got the nail, and what else? I'm not sure what item this is. You can see it on the side since I enabled that other, HED. Anyway, so we did have a soul heart, but we lost all that trying to get used to this item. See, if I'm close up next to these guys, I can take them out in basically one shot. 2 of diamonds, okay. So I can tell right now what we're going to need is range. And I'm not sure how well range can actually be increased with this item. Gonna find out at some point. Monster manual or the nail? I am taking the nail because the nail, as it says, temporary demon form, but at the same time it gives me a black heart, and that is just more useful. So yeah, I want to be up. It gives me a soul heart. That's still fine. You see, I want to be as close as I can since the damage decreases quite rapidly. Oops. And there's a reason I don't want to be close. Yeah, this is an interesting item. We'll see how well this goes. I don't know. Anyways, there we go. We just defeated Duke of Flies. Pretty easy. Shot speed and damage up. I'll take shot speed up. Looks like they gave us a little bit of range. Oh yeah, well, on the demon form I can just step on things. Alright, moving on. Two of diamonds we're going to save until we have some diamonds to use on it. Excuse me, some coins. With 3 keys I could just take this, and I think why not, let's do it. Alright, got a soul heart out of it. I'm not going to use that just yet. You see, we start with very large damage. Let the fire makes quick work of those guys. Let's go in here. What is this? Black hole. You know, I think this is one of the new items. I'll try in a room and see, but I think I know what this is going to do. Nothing can escape, is what it says. So let's go to a room like this. If I use it, I can throw it. It sucks everything into the black hole and kills him. I don't know if it always kills him, but it did that time. So, this seems like an interesting item. Is it better than the nail? I don't know. I kind of just want to use it just because it's new. But, we'll see how it works on bosses. That's another question. Is even worth it. Because, I'll tell you what, having a soul heart generator is pretty useful. Yeah, I don't know, I kind of just, since it's new, and I've never really used it, I kind of just want to take it. But, again, that may not be the smart thing to do. I think it's awesome, though, that there actually are workshop items in the real game. That's a really cool idea. Alright, get over here. Now, if I can actually do damage, I can do a lot of damage. Especially if I'm willing to be up close. Okay, watch out for these troll bombs. Whoa! Alright, what do we have here? Joker is going to take us to the Devil Room. I'm going to get Devil Room 100%. So I'm going to save this, and I will bring that Joker with me to the next floor. And we're going to see what this does when we get to the boss room, how much damage it does. The Haunt. That's good. This is a boss I dislike. So once we get take these ghosts out, he'll show his face. Now I'll throw it. Not much. Looks like it's maybe glitched out even. Alright. HP up. And this gives us an opportunity to take something here if we feel like it. And I could take the damage up or not. I don't think I'm going to. So, might as well use two diamonds now since I'm going to bring Joker with me. Well, I should have waited until I picked up that one coin, but whatever. Not that much of a difference. So we're doing alright so far. Curse of the Unknown. So I don't know how much health I have. The easy way to solve this curse is just don't take damage. Easy. The simplest way, I suppose. Alright, I'll take Petrified Poop. Alright, we're gonna get Sister Maggie. Just familiar. Not great, but not exactly bad either. Whoops, I just took a full heart of damage. So it means I have 1.5 soul hearts, I think. Sack. Hanged Man and the Emperor. Well, let's just do it, why not? Thing is, I want to be as close as I can to do the most damage. Oh boy. I took a lot of damage though. Speed and range up, well, that range up is helpful. And now we can finish off the floor. A range up is effectively the same as a damage up with this setup. Ideally, we can defeat these guys over the gaps. They won't spawn anything, but I think I'm out of soul hearts. Also, I could have used my item. I forgot about that black hole. Let's use it now. Oh, it even breaks the rocks. That's pretty cool. It's a neat item. I don't know, maybe the nail was a smarter choice, but I don't know, sometimes you just want to take the fun item. Oops. Shoot, I have to be careful, because since I don't know how much health I have. I imagine it's probably getting low, though. I need to get this guy out soon. Go. You know, in a way, my character kind of works like Azazel does, where if I get really close, I can do a lot of damage. So maybe I can use some of the similar strategies. Alright, come at me. There we go. Part of me kind of wants to take some pills, but I don't know if I should. I do have several of them. There's a heart back. Let's try it. Bombs are key. Well, it did not do much. Let's see what's in here. Why not? Let's do it. We got a payout out of that. So it looks like our health is full, since I cannot pick up the hearts. Alright, let's finish it out. Alright, that should be it. So we got a bunch of coins out of that. Now we can go to the shop if we want to, and I think I will. Health up. Alright, now that I found the health up, that's probably the most useful one. I'm not really going to worry about pills anymore. Oh, and then we got the Bible. Shoot, black hole, it's been fun, but we got to take the Bible. That's one of the best items. Since, after all, it does kill Mom instantly. And I've said many times, Mom is a boss I'm not good at. And you know, we can also use it just to pick these up. Alright. Yeah, this is a place where we could have used Black Hole. I might at some point use Bomb to get over there, though. Seems to be a sweet spot to take these guys out where I can hit him maybe two hits at a certain distance. So I want to hit him where I can obviously do enough damage to him, but still still be safe from the explosions. Okay. Come on, step in the fire. We go. Some enemies are smart enough to avoid the fire. It doesn't seem like all of them are, though. Especially on these like cauliflower looking guys, we're able to get close because they don't do contact damage. Some bosses, again, I think it's going to work better on some bosses than others. Like Isaac, let's see. Yeah, we're going to have to go against Isaac if we get the opportunity, just because we haven't beaten him yet, but Isaac is not going to work quite as well just because of his attacks, his circular, wide range attacks. Split the gap. Just keep firing. We're almost done. There we go. Tried to dodge it, walked right into it. Hmm. Two bombs for chest? Let's do it. We got enough bombs. Alright, three coins. One bomb for one golden chest. Let's also do that. Alright. There's the boss fight. Let's finish out the floor real quick. And get our item too. So we got health after that. I'm not going to take any more pills. Since I know which one's the health up, I'm only going to take it if I see that it is that. We don't have very high fire rate. That is one thing we could improve on right now. So, I mean, that's really the only reason, other reason to take pills, is to try and increase that stat. But, I don't know. It's probably good to be safe. And I'm gonna destroy all these poops just because I have lucky poop. Or petrified poop. This toxic blood. My guess is this has something to do with when I take damage, but I guess we'll find out. Alright, so we have two soul hearts, which we'll take once we're finished with this fight. Mega fatty. Ooh. In a small room, too. That fast jump always gets me. Because all the other bosses don't have jumps like that. I'm just gonna stand in here. Oops. Well, that was a destructive run. I'm gonna be able to heal it all though I have enough health left. Crack jacks. Liberty Cap, or Petrified Poop, and I'll take that. So let's put a bomb there. Here we can actually go to the item room, or the, whatever it's called, the shop, and I think I'm going to do that also. Okay, so one bomb gets us across. What we got. Greed. It's not too bad, actually. Again, I think getting greed early is good. Because it just gives us options, it makes it so we're not going to see greed again. Unless we get a super greed, but yeah, it's not super likely. Okay. I'm not moving very quickly. That's not really the end of the world. The tower, I'll take that. Be careful about these guys. They have hidden range. Yeah, you have to actually move quite quickly to stay out of the way. Since we want to be close, of course, we just can't be too close. Hopefully we can get a devil deal. Or at the very least an angel room. Because I have 5 health. And we could make use of that. Okay, could get challenge banned, which I think I'm gonna do. Damage and challenge up. I think this damage up is gonna be quite helpful, yeah. Ooh, did not see that fly down there. Thankfully, we still have 100% chance of a double room. I really want to know what this king, this crown symbol is. Is he like a super version or something? Yeah, so when I see all these batteries wear, I start to maybe regret a little bit not taking the nail. Because all of those batteries could be turned into soul hearts. But oh well. I think the Bible's a good trade-off. I think I might have been a little bit worse off if I kept with the black hole, as fun as that item is. But the Bible is like, it's quite useful. Especially since I know that Mom is a boss I'm not very good at. I'm pretty good at Mom's heart, slash it lives though. And I think that's a health up pill. Nope. Ugh, I stepped right on the thing on the ground. Neither of these are. So we'll keep the tower with us. What's the problem? It seems like I'm doing... Yeah, I guess when I take damage, I start doing a blood trail. What is this? Hot bombs? You know, on second thought, I probably should have re-rolled that. Whatever, I'll take what I can get. Blood bank. Portable blood bank. I think that's where... Oh, I know what it is. That's where you... It's like the blood donation machine. The thing about the Bible is I just really don't use it. All until I get to the fights. But the thing is, it's essentially worth 2 boss fights. And honestly, I kind of just forget I have it. I do deal quite a bit of damage up close, though. It's pretty cool. But yeah, I'm hoping for this devil deal to go well. I could use a brimstone even. It might be kind of nice. I mean, brimstone's always nice. Honestly, it's a big reason why I do devil deals. Just because I might get a brimstone. Alright, let's finish it out. I think. You know, we really don't have to, though. But why not? Let's do it. Oops, I actually used the tower. Ugh, I took damage from it. Oh boy, that is dumb, isn't it? Okay. Well, at least this is worth something now. That was really dumb, wasn't it? It just happens though, like, because I'm on a laptop, so I mean, sometimes if you just move your fingers too quickly, it can happen where you just take that damage. Ultra Pride. Ooh. Yeah, those ranged, like, aimed ones are rough. The left hand is going to make all of our chests black chest or red chests. Which I think I'm gonna take. Yeah, you see, we don't have any more hearts anywhere. Except for maybe in the shop. Yeah. So I think my decision to finish that out was maybe not the best advised one. I'm just gonna turn my phone off real quick. Alright. I could use one of those pills if I wanted to, but I mean, if I got health down, I would be kicking myself, so I'm not going to. There are a few difficult bosses that could be coming up, so we'll see what it is. Alright, Brownie. It's a champion variant. I gotta be close. I think we'll do alright, though. Yeah, he's almost out. I did take damage, unfortunately, but, Oops. Oh, he's out. That's it. Oh. Boy, yeah, I kind of got caught off guard. I thought he was gonna... wasn't gonna spawn those guys. I thought he was gonna spawn a Dingle. Alright, damage and range up is about the best thing we could have, though, right now. Both damage and range. Because they're basically equivalent. It's like, up close we do a lot of damage, but like... even from, like... third of a floor away, we still do a pretty decent amount. But 15 starting damage is awesome. Alright, so let's pick up this black heart. Make sure that's all we need. Yep, and move on. Curse of Darkness? Maybe not. Just a dark floor. Boom. Hit its weak point for massive damage. Health up. Yep.
Health up.
Okay, yeah, could not quite squeak by there. Okay, I think I'm about there. Just got, like, a little stuck. Now we can check out the arcade. We will use these later. Oops. There's options we could take for 15. That's something, if I can get that, I'll do. If not, I'll just donate. And a bomb for a chest is probably worth it. Oh, no. Prayer card is good. Ah, it's good. But it's not as good as the Bible. It's just not. I mean, so we're going to finish out the floor and find our... Oh, no. I did not want to do that. I really did not. Anyways, we need to find the whatever it's called, the item room. We can just take him out. Hopefully he won't even drop a bomb. There we go. Got health up out of that. Oops. Nah. I'm playing a little sloppily right now. I gotta tighten this up. Pretty soon, though. Yeah, I am getting lucky, though, and getting hearts. Oh, boy. One bomb for 9 red chests? It's probably worth it. See, this type of fire doesn't take damage, but sometimes there are enemies that can spawn fire that looks exactly like it. There's the other thing. These can spawn. I can take them out in one hit, though. If I can hit him, that is. High Priestess. Ah, Dry Baby. Thank you. Oops. Taking a lot of damage here. Yeah, the thing about red chests is they're not always good. Luckfoot? Whatever, I'll take it. I don't know why I went here. I think I'm done with this floor. Unless I really want to just try and get my health back, but I don't know what the chance of that is. Alright, so now I gotta remember, because I am not gonna be able to come back. I almost want to take a pill. I almost. Oh no. I made it. I don't know if I've ever done that before. Okay. Anyways, we're not gonna be able to come back here. So let's go pick up this heart. And we're gonna go and donate to this guy all the way. And he drops fanny pack. Alright, we can blow this up, get some health out of it. Hopefully. Maybe not. I'm gonna blow both of these guys. I should probably donate to this guy, actually. I think I'll do that. That's the problem with the red chest, though. It's oftentimes, they are either neutral or not good at all. Attack fly, it's better than nothing. Alright, we gotta have a heart out of that. We did go up. Looks like we're... Yeah, no, I don't understand, because these percentages don't add up. Whatever. Use the Bible, the halos appear in the basement. Ah, PJs. That gives me a lot. And we get prayer card, but I can't take it. We have 6 hearts, though. That's gonna be fine. So these enemies, I think they're called nerve endings. Whoops. They don't do any damage to you unless you just go up and touch them. But there are some that are, like, these are red. There are orange ones that will actually lash out at you. You gotta be careful about the difference. Now, I generally dislike going into these narrow rooms because there's so many difficult rooms that are the narrow ones. But whatever, I just have a hunch that this is the right way to go. I need to get this portal out of the way. Okay, it's gone. Oh yeah, did you see what happened? Dry Baby, I forgot to I don't know if I mentioned what it did, but Dry Baby, when he takes damage, he'll sometimes do the Necronomicon. I think Necronomicon is how you say it, effect. And damage all the enemies in the room. So basically, he's just around there. He'll block shots for you, and sometimes those block shots will turn into damage. It's a very good item, especially if you use it right. You can, yeah, on some bosses, like Mom's Heart or It Lives, it's very useful because there's just so many shots going around. Oops. That was a mistake. Some of these guys, I just... Oops. There we go, he blocked another one. Thanks, buddy. So you see, he's a good item. He's a good one to have up your sleeve. Use this now. And deal a lot of damage to him. About to take him out. Come on. There we go. Placenta. Mental Sense is good, because if I ever get in a bind, I can just stop and wait, and I will replenish my HP. Alright. We're on the move. Sloppy. I was about to say I got through that without taking damage, and then I took two full hearts. Oh, great. Two of these guys. Okay, we have to play to dodge here. The nice thing is they can't hurt each other with their own bombs, which I've said before is kind of a strange thing, but... Oops. I don't know, maybe it's trying to teach us a lesson about wrath, how you can hurt yourself. I don't know. Alright, and we got an arcade, so let's see what's in the arcade. Ooh, we got a bomb bigger. I'm not sure I've ever seen one of these guys before. I'll come back here later. The one thing about the arcade is it's the only room that I know of where there's no bad versions of it. Except for the angel room, I guess. Okay, so there's a couple of them. But, like, the devil room definitely has the Krampus fight. And, like, the shop, you can get greed, etc. Now, if I can get a charge up, I could actually use the Bible to get up there. But since I need the Bible for this next fight, I don't really want to use it right now. We need to take out that guy on the wall. Because he'll break free eventually. There we go. Alright, two soul hearts. I'm not going to use it, though. Ooh. Shoot, I see. I just take damage sometimes from things I can't see. I think it's just because the red is the same color as the shots they fire. Okay. So I'm gonna try and hit this out of the way. Actually, gonna blow it out of the way. Because I don't want to use it right now. Ah! Look at all these. I'm gonna take a lot of damage here, I think, but the thing is I can recover it. Because I do have placenta, and that's why I want to survive as long as I can without soul hearts. These guys shouldn't be a problem if we're smart. And another soul heart. Some good... Oh, yeah, whoa. Thanks, Dry Baby. I actually really needed that. I'm not sure how I was going to take all those guys out. Great. This is a difficult. This is a difficult room. Sometimes you just gotta move. All right. Did all right though. Now, one thing I could do, if I have the patience for it, is go to the sacrifice room and just start making sacrifices. Since I can do as many as I want, since I have infinite regeneration. But am I really willing to wait for all of those? Okay, I think, since I haven't done it before, I think I'm going to go donate to the bomb bigger. Well, thanks. Is he just going to drop bombs? Doesn't make sense. He's giving away more than I'm giving him. I have a lot of them. I just want to see what his vital item is. It's probably like some bomb-related item. Come on. Oh, he blew himself up. Well, I'll take that. And you saw I just replenished health because of Placenta. Now, Bomb Heal, take both of these guys out. Sorry. And we can pick up our Soul Hearts and go fight the next boss, except for we don't have to fight, because we got the Bible. Okay, let's see. I need to go upstairs. That's where I haven't been yet. Why not? I have excess of both bombs and keys. I got some blue spiders. Better than nothing. Monstro! At least three monsters. Yeah, three. This is a place where Dry Baby might take some damage and do some damage also. Ugh. Like that. Problem is, I know this is why they do this. You know the pattern for one. It's hard to figure out the pattern for all of them at once. Guppy's Paw. That's a soul converter. That will be useful at some point. Basically, every time I use this, I think it converts one heart to either two or three soul hearts. It's basically free hearts, though, and if we're going to bring that into the boss fight, no doubt. Because as I run low, I can convert heart containers. And it's a great item to have if you just need to use a lot of hearts. Great. Not great. I hate this room. Because I hate each of the enemies in them. Especially... Sorry. These dumb ghosts. The leeches are probably worse, though. So once we get these ghosts out of the way, we should be alright. And I mean, that's all we have left anyway, so. Yeah, those holy leeches. They have that fly which can block shots. I'm pretty sure they're exclusive to the cathedral. Oops. Thanks, Dry Baby. You know I needed that right there. Alright, Widow. Very easy boss. You know, I kind of like just fighting all these bosses in a row. I think it's pretty fun. That's why I like Boss Rush. It's fun if you can do it, you know. You can't always do it, that's for sure. Ah. I am taking some damage, though. I do have some heart containers saved up, though. I should pick these up. Because I'm going to use that soul converter when I get the chance. There's really no reason to use it until I get to the boss, though. We need to get these spawners out of the way before it spawns more of these. Thanks, Dry Baby. Dry Baby is a great item. Great, great. Okay. What is this? 5 poison bombs? Alright, just finish this out. And then we'll be good to go. Come on, dodge, dodge, dodge. Alright, still took some damage. But maybe Dry Baby can help me out. Dry Baby is really going to be useful against Isaac, though, because he has a multitude of tier-based attacks. Alright, one down. Alright, let's go pick up our Soul Converter. And we can just use it now and see exactly how useful it is. Oh, we got a marked rock. Anyways, so like this guppy's paw, I really don't like to use it hardly ever, unless I know this is gonna be my final boss. Like if I use it. Okay, so looks like I gained 3 soul hearts from 1 heart. I think it did it even though that heart wasn't completely full. So basically I net 2. Oops. But boy, see, I need to be close up to him to really do damage. I think even with all this extra, I might not be able to take him out. There we go, we need to get him into this form. Baby, help me out, buddy. Thank you. That's gonna be close, even so. I don't know where to stand to dodge these, also, is the problem. I don't use my converter just yet because I have these hearts saved up. That spawned from something, I don't know what. So now I'll use it, and now I will convert. And I just gotta stand in here. I'm almost there, but... it's gonna be close. It really is. I think I dodged that one. Thanks, Dry Baby. I think it's awesome that I didn't even get him from like an item room or anything. He was inside of a skull. And Dry Baby does the finishing touch, and that took a lot of HP out of us. But we got it done. I've forgotten how much health Isaac has. Alright, see if we unlocked anything. A blink card appeared in the basement. Binding RetroGamingNow, playing the Binding of Isaac after Plus, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Have a great day.